Tesla Jung. I'm here with Ajay Puri. He has a Bachelor's of Science from BioPsych, as well as he's doing his PhD at UBC right now. He's involved with many grassroots organizations, and he's very passionate about social justice. So many people think that the pitch is just for the corporate setting, but you're very involved with social justice. So how has that helped you?
Yeah, I mean, a pitch is just building relationships for me. So when I go and approach different people, I want to tell my story or the stories of the people I represent or that I'd like to work with. So if it's a homeless person on the street or if it's a visible minority or if it's a youth or an elder, I love sharing those people's stories. So to be able to narrate their story, it's very important. So even though it's not about getting a business client, it's about building a relationship. So whether it be with the media or whether it be with a nonprofit or whether it be with somebody else in the community, so that if a new building goes up in the neighborhood, how do different people in that neighborhood get along? And it's about pitching continually to ensure the empowered communities work together.
So building relationships is really important, and you mentioned that you've had mentors who have helped you in the panel discussion. So for recent graduates who are looking out to reach out to a mentor, how can they start to build that relationship?
Mm-hmm. Well, first is actually to get out there. So there's different networking events all over town in different industries. So whatever you're passionate about, if it's music, if it's science, if it's going into medicine, get out there, get into those industries, get to know people. Everything is about people. So once you get to know people, the next step is to then take those business cards that you've gotten or those emails or read people's bios, is then to engage with them. So out of the 10 cards you might have, the idea would be to see who would reply, right? And those that reply and are very positive and they remember you and you made a good relationship with them, then you can say, hey, look, this is where I am. Can you nominate someone? I'm looking for somebody to mentor me in this field. And then they would either say yes or no, or they say, I'd love to do it. And then you start that informal channel. And you don't have to make anything formal. The idea is to say, here's where I am right now, here's the problems, you know, can you help me with these issues? So say you're starting up a new business, or say you're an artist and you want to get your CD launched, or say you're a social justice activist and you want to have a big rally coming up.
Right.
The idea would be to then get the mentor to help you get those networks or get the planning in place and say, hey, I have an event organizer for you, here you go. So the idea is to start slowly,
yeah,
and don't expect everything in the same day, right? So the idea is to continue that relationship, and over time, that mentor will be an informal mentor.
Okay.
So you can either have formal mentors or informal, and I think both are very strong.
So sometimes you don't have to explicitly say, will you be my mentor? That relationship will already be.
Exactly, and you can just ask for advice. I think that's the key biggest thing, is taking people's knowledge and leveraging it for what you're doing. And the 5 minutes you have for their idea, for your idea, might be worth more than trying out the whole idea yourself. So instead of spending 6 months and doing the project, some mentor or some person might give you some advice on it,
right,
and really redirect you on a way that makes that project a lot better. And it's happened a lot of times with me, like for Bridge to a Cool Planet, we got 10,000 people on the bridge, but it wouldn't happen overnight and without collaborations and mentors.
Right.
So people with their networks helped us build our name, and then we leveraged that credibility and knowledge and information to make the event successful.
Now, Ajay, it's quite safe to say that you're a man of many interests. What is one piece of advice that you have for recent graduates who are looking to incorporate their passion into their work right now?
It's really key. I think the new generations moving forward, we saw the recession, and now it's the ability of people to have a personality. And I think the best way to do that is actually to be very professional and speak your voice. So come from a point of inclusion and social justice where you actually say your points thinking of all people. So you don't make rude remarks, so you don't make, you know, racist remarks, but you also come from your heart. So I would really recommend people who have their passion to really think hard about what it is and just go at it. So set up a blog. If you're comfortable with it, it's very easy. Set up a Twitter handle, do something on Facebook, or do something that in a platform that you're comfortable with, and just try it out. Test it, see how it goes. For the first 3 months, don't shoot yourself in the foot if nobody read your article. And don't get mad at yourself if some person on your blog is like writing to you negatively about it.
Right.
Just keep testing different things, and certain things will fly, and you would have had no idea that people like that content. So somebody just asked me tonight about music, he said, I have no story to tell. I'm just a recent grad. I'm doing this degree. What do I, you know, what can I do? I'm like, well, what do you like? What do you do in your spare time? What did you do yesterday? He's like, well, I listened to music. Mm-hmm. I said, I would love to hear and read your blog on music. What kind of music? He said, rock music. Mm-hmm. I said, even better. I have no idea about rock music. If you reviewed CDs, bands that came to town, and then you posted those articles in different news outlets online, that would be so exciting for me as a person. And he said he just moved to East Vancouver.
Right.
And so for me to say, I live in East Vancouver and you're my neighbor and I read your information about the concert that you went to that I want, like to go but I couldn't, it makes that personality and that personal side of the story and it grows your passion. Mm-hmm. And a lot of people can leverage that and then start making money off of it. Mm-hmm. As a community organizer or as a, I guess, a consultant.
Well, thank you so much for your time, Ash.
Thanks, Angela. That was great.
Thank you.